Mr. President.
Secretary General.
Condolences to the Freshman Brothers. Diplomatic. People, it was a great shock for all of us. You know, that's a good one. As Assistant Secretary General for Political Defense, and of course, your ambassador and your own people.
Yes. Come in.
Where do you want me?
Leave.
Very much appreciate it, because it is one of the big issues, if not the biggest issue we are facing this year in Europe, and here in the United States. And if you allow me to go on, because I'll tell you about it.
Mr. President, I see you. For coming over here, I know there are congressional concerns about Central America. I know your committee's special interest in the Nicaragua problem. We've tried hard to keep you informed of the developments there and other places in our backyard in Central America. But let me assure you that we are not in contravention of the Boland Amendment. And even the Nicaraguan foreign minister has said that the Contras, as they call them, the exiles opposing the Sandinista government, are not a threat to his government. Our purpose in providing assistance is to interdict the arms that are destined for the guerrillas in El Salvador. Arms that, as the events of last week demonstrate, often originate from outside our hemisphere, as witnessed the planes in Brazil. But I think that the issue is more profound than just that and weapons. I think we do have a moral responsibility that now we're actively engaged within Nicaragua, because if we cut off their support, we sentence them to death. And they are the ones who are looking toward elections, pluralism, and freedom. And anyone who's looking toward that in Nicaragua will be dealt a severe blow. And I think we also signaled a friend and foe alike that we're not a very reliable partner. The situation is so different in Nicaragua that we have to be aware that those who are now the Contras, as they call them, were one time part of this revolution. And then, as we've seen happen in others, we saw it happen after we, the United States, forced a country named Laos, back before the Vietnam War, into taking a coalition government with the communists in their own country. Found out that all we'd done is deliver Laos to a communist government. But what has happened in Nicaragua is that these people, once revolutionaries, part of the whole attempt to throw over Somoza, were exiled and thrown out because they wanted democracy, and the government that's now in power in Nicaragua doesn't. But the challenge, I think, to our ideals goes well beyond Nicaragua. It has the potential of engulfing the entire Central America region. As you're aware, I'm going to be speaking to a joint session. I understand that isn't the most common undertaking. It hasn't taken place too often, but I'll be doing that tomorrow night. I want to steer a steady bipartisan course. Unless we continue to help our neighbors protect themselves, they and ultimately we will be faced with extremely grave consequences. And I am going to urge Congress to continue to support the 3-to-1 mix of economic and military aid that we have carefully designed to serve as a shield for democratization and development and human rights. It has been actually a little more than that. It's been about 70 cents out of every dollar is going for economic aid so far. And the remainder is in for the small bit of military assistance that we give. But let me underline that, I think I've said enough because we better get out of it. I know that Bill's got some things.
Damn congressman there loused me up, and I'm going by my schedule now. Dude's be making a speech over in the state dining room. But,
that's all right.
Let's sit down here for a minute.
How they treat you on the job programs that are coming back to the States. We have tried to make sure that the old CETA structure doesn't swallow up what's there.
We don't want that either.
It's going to require, in some cases, the help of the Department of Labor. The regional offices will well-staffed by the previous administration, so we're going to try to...